I'd like to record a message today about cleansing from evil passions. I had a lot of videos about it in the past, about fasts, vigils, prayers on the knees and alms, and today I'd like to add one important, valuable method about cleansing from evil passions. It's strict food. Strict food is this, to cut the story short, this is a loaf of bread, brick of bread, so to say. It's gray bread. It has no sugar, so you eat twice a day like this, two bricks a day, and water, and it's considered to be strict food for which Jesus also cleanses evil passions. Also, different days you can eat this. This is lentils, you just boil it, and you can also boil this. This is a type of wheat. This is a special type of wheat. I'm not sure how it's called in English. You can boil it and mix it together with lentils, or you can just eat lentils or both wheat and lentils together. This is also considered strict food. Jesus cleanses from passions for this food also. If you just eat this and water two times a day, that's what early church fathers ate. Many of them ate just bread and water their whole life. Some of them ate this, maybe more lentils than this, but you can mix it, it's all good. And I'm not calling you to eat just bread or just that, because you will get proud, because they built themselves up to it from childhood, you know, they were training in Christian life like that from childhood, and they were very high level Christians, and for me, I consider it's even like a very big stupidity to think that I ever will be eating like them or living like them, you know, because they built themselves up and from pure. You know me, I have a big history of sin in my life before I followed Jesus, so I just consider if Jesus saves me into the furthest corner of heaven, I'm super happy and most happy in whole universe, and I'm just like a little guinea pig in his kingdom. And I advise you to think also same thing about yourself. That's what Jesus taught me, that's the right way to think about yourself, and not that you're doing all this stuff to become spiritually rich, because you're doing it to not be in hell, where we ought to be right now by his justice. You know, and it's Peter also said that if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the sinner and ungodly appear? So this is a huge, gem, because which I share with you, because you will find the benefits of it. To cut the story short, for this also, you do it not instead of fasts, not instead of vigils, but on top of them some of the days. And you will see how Jesus cleanses you, and you will see that he can give revelations about his kingdom. He can give you better character when you do all this. You can see that you will become more easygoing on all kind of good works when you eat like this. The soul has like wings. It's easy to do all that stuff, easier, so to say. So I'm sharing it with you like with a gem, and I also saying that those people who tried fast and vigils, they can experience that at some days evil attacks them very strong, and it seems like it's not working. It's not that it's not working, it's just they pick up days when they attack you to make you think it's not working, but the whole background of passions is dropping, and the person becomes more and more growing slowly more and more into a more virtuous person. But it takes the whole life to get cleansed from passions, and not to become spiritually rich, but to get saved. That's the biggest aim, you know, into the furthest corner of heaven, because most people, most Christians, and they're going to hell. That's the thing. May Jesus bless you.